Welp. That sucks. Time to grind for gems. Boop, boop, boop. This is very ambitious. I think I'll just take Druid of the Cowl. Real Bloodlord is just a fun build around. Building into the life gain deck. So looking for synergies. Boop, boop, boop. Best of one, I don't really want duress. Trusty Rusty, probably not going to play that. I think I'm just happy with another Luminous Bonds. Ooh, I hope this wheels. Yeah, I need artifacts though, and I'm just not gonna have enough. I'll take this first. I mean, I think Luminous Bonds is better, but I mean, Luminous Bonds is better, though. Oh, baby. Courser. I think I want the Courser. I've already got two Epicures. Gravedigger's tempting, but I'm going to take the spores. Oh, baby. I just need some more four drops, I think. I've already got three. Just getting more of them is so tempting, but I already have three. Oh, another courser. Embarrassment of riches over here. Don't need that. Boop, boop, boop. Too many three drops, I think. Yeah. That feels a little better. Okay. Yeah, I went through that. I went through that a little quick. I didn't really explain what I was thinking, but pretty focused on just getting through this pretty quickly. Yeah, pretty simple idea here. Corset draft, not very complicated. Ooh, the Pride Mate Chaplain combo. I was willing to trade there. I have enough other life gain sources. Or he can, you know, attack me with the mare. I'm the life gain deck. I can afford to just take damage. That hurts. That hurts. Boop, boop, boop. So I can Skeleton Archer his mare next turn. That was a mistake. You should have put it on the elemental. I mean, I am rank bronze, so these games should be easy. Because I haven't done any drafting since they introduced real rank. It's good to, you know, rank up from the draft set I'm comfortable with, so that then later when I draft a set I'm not comfortable with, but my rank is higher, I can lose even harder. If you don't play, you always lose. I could have attacked. It's not like my Vampire Nurse Hero actually doesn't have Defender, which I honestly think is a little weird. See if he blocks. He did not. Okay. That's fine. Actually, there are two ways I can do this. Is he gonna cast an instant? He is. I mean, this is why I waited. That's why I waited to do it then. Could have held that land. Alright, now I've got a ping target for my archer. Nice. Full value. Yeah, I don't think there's any reason to be scared of draft. It's better if you actually, like, if you read up on the set and kind of have a sense of the cards, at least. It's way less intimidating. Also, drafting on Arena, where you can take, like, I highly recommend jumping into draft in Arena and just taking all the time in the world. Like, zero rush. Because you have no time limit, and that's the huge advantage that this drafting on here has over drafting in real life or on MTGO. It's just, you've got all the time in the world. So you can even, like, go read pick lists stuff, just, like, get information on cards, really think about every choice you make. Well, I'm taking that six. But that's a juicy Luminous Bonds target. I gotta say. Does he have a combat trick? He does. Well, I'm happy to just get that out of the way. Blocks. I still feel like it's not worth it for me to trade. Because I'm kind of in a position to just deal him damage. Neonate attack. Hello. All right. I can play the Epicure next turn. Oof. 6 damage. Oh no, they double fly. Block that. Person with no flyers anyway. So if he has removal, I could be in trouble. My gamble paid off. That's enough of that. Double flying. His own Pegasus Courser. Damn. Okay, that's the wrong choice. Should have done it on this Drillmaster so he could attack with both of them through. Tempted to double block the line breaker with my coursers. This is more tempting. See if he trades. So I could triple block the Herald of Faith. It's risking of being blown out, but it's a thing I can do. 7. I think that's game, unless he's got... Yeah, there's nothing. There's nothing in that set that could save him at that point. No, I'm too good. I can't find a match. Man, that was like the longest wait time I've ever had in arena. I don't think that many people are playing this format. I'm literally only doing it to farm gems. And because it's still, you know, magic. Can't underestimate the power of it just being fun to play magic. Even if it's not the new hotness. Not full value, but what are you gonna do? Rather play things on curve and not waste my luminous bonds yet. That's not scary. That's annoying. I still feel like I should save my luminous bonds. Part of me that wants to use it on the courser, but... I don't want him drawing a card. I don't want any of that to happen. I was tempted to use Inspiring Charge there, but not if I can Regal Bloodlord. We might have a counterspell, though. I kind of walked into that. Ugh. I don't think I can afford to attack it anymore. God damn it. No problem. I don't need an active chat while I'm playing Arena. Or anything. Happy to have whoever wants to chat around. Happy to be background noise. Respect the tempo play. I would like to not draw more land, though. Gotta say. Yeah, you kind of just have to accept that sometimes when you play Magic the Gathering, you're not going to get your lands. It's just not going to happen. And understand the... If you build your deck right, it's going to happen, whatever, this small percentage of times. And you only really notice it strongly when it doesn't work out. Let's see if he has a counterspell. Attack. I probably should. But I kind of want to be able to get him with Inspiring Charge on defense if I can. That's... Yeah, okay. He's still getting me the double life loss value out of the Neonate. I'm so low on cards, though. Either way, I think I'm playing Inspiring Charge. Inspired Charge. Whether he blocks or not. So I can survive one extra card draw on his part, but I cannot survive two. Yes! He didn't have anything. Whew. Fun thing about this format is while you might not have things that are that strong, neither do your opponents. The power level of cards is pretty low overall in a core set. No white mana, but turn one Neonate is where I want to be. This is particularly good against the blue deck. That's gonna, like, be sitting back. Though I would like to draw a Plains now. Not a Plains. Plains would be good. Nice. Jank Blue is pretty good. I'm a fan of Jank Blue. Remember, if you're just doing the normal cues and you're playing with Jank, you are more likely to just get paired with Jank too. This game is pretty well... It's pretty well positioned for Jank to work out for you. That Drake is actually scary, but not that scary. Still more inclined to play my 5-mana drop into him being tapped out. Like, if you're throwing together Jank to do the daily, you're probably going to play someone else who's doing a similar thing of playing Jank to do the daily. Depending, you know, on the quality of your Jank. And it can be a fun time. Ooh. Okay, this is too tempting. Let's see if he counters this or something. Yep. And now I can get my courser through. Good, 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 good. Sleep. Well, it's not a deal breaker sleep, so I'm okay. Tempted to build rats. Rats is not that good. Just be aware. I just don't want to deal with this anymore. I'm only attacking with the chaplain to trigger the life gain, to trigger the epicure of blood life loss. Oh, I should have tapped Neonate in response. Oh well. Well, that's annoying, but it's not the end of the world. Oh God, that I know. Ooh, Gen of Wishes is so friggin' good. Oh man. Now I do feel like I'm in trouble. Also, did I forget to neonate? I don't even remember. Friggin' free cards! This is a worst case scenario block, I think. Oh, it's only plus one attack, damn. Well, plus one defense. I've screwed up. If you're frustrated with drawing all your lands, honestly, I would suggest deck with cantrips and card draw spells. Because when you draw extra cards, or you have like a loot mechanic, it can mitigate a lot of that stuff, particularly in the frustration department. It's not only just good, it also makes you feel more like you're in control, which is why people like playing blue. These walls. We're getting close to this game being over one way or another. Still got one wish left. Yeah, I'm super dead. Oh well, first loss. Ugh, if I hadn't tapped that, I could have lived. I kind of blew that. I got a little too greedy at the last minute. Didn't think it through. I underestimated him. Could have played the tap land first, but I don't really have anything to do on turn two, so. Might as well play the one drop. That 03 though. That life gain though. Now I'm content to just sit here. He's got two goblins. Aha! All the 2/2s. Now, if he had combined shock with Volley Veteran, then he could have gotten somewhere. Killed my Epicure. Oh man. Oh, I only have 3 mana. I thought I had 4. I fucked up. I got complacent again. Ugh. Fuck that up. Nope. Fuck me. God damn it. I guess I have to stop after this because I'm playing dumb now. I've thrown 2 games in a row. I don't think there's another point in playing the other Neone yet. That card is just annoying enough to Luminous Bonds. Damn it. God damn. Yep, that's game. God damn it. Ugh.